3 on fluid statics. In the first two sessions, we have seen in detail that pressure is a scalar quantity, then pressure is an important parameter in a, for fluids. For solids, we use the equilibrium condition for equating two forces, but in fluids, we go for the pressure. Now, in the third session, let us see what are the outcomes that I expect. You will see that at the end of this session, learner will be able to show that a liquid may exert thrust greater than its weight and define Pascal's law and enumerate its application. Now let us see. First, we will discuss about the Pascal's law, and then we will see about the thrust exerted by the body is greater than the weight of the fluid that is contained. Now, very important thing is, pressure exerted, suppose I take this particular say system in which the left limb has small diameter and the right limb has a large diameter. As already we have studied that if the liquid is same, if the liquid is same in this container, then the pressure at this point and pressure at this point is same. Now pressure at A and pressure at B is same. So what happens if I apply here some force, so F upon A is small. So because F upon A1, this area of this section is A1, area of this section is say A2. So F upon A1, when I apply it, then what happens? The pressure developed is large because A is small. This pressure is applied over here. And this pressure multiplied by, so pressure at B is equal to pressure at A, which is equal to F upon A1. Then force at B is equal to pressure at B into area at B. Now pressure at B is F upon A1 into A2. Now I know that A2 is greater than A1. Therefore, FB is greater than FA. So what happens? By small force, I can lift here a big object that is put over here. Now for this, we have used a very important property of a fluid, that is pressure exerted or pressure developed is immediately communicated to entire liquid without any loss, and that law is known as Pascal's law. Now, first of all, before going to see various applications of Pascal's law, one more thing I want to make it clear, that whenever we want to evaluate exactly how the pressure is calculated as we move deep inside the liquid, let us see. Suppose I take this as a container in which, say, at this, suppose there is a atmospheric pressure I denote by P0. Then I take some element here whose width is, say, dy and at a height of y. So what is my concept now? From the surface where the atmospheric pressure is acting, I am coming down by a distance of y meters, and I take a element whose, say, thickness is dy, and suppose its area is, say, A. So what is the volume of this element? Volume of this element is A into dy. Volume of this element is A into dy. So if I multiply this volume by rho, density of the particular this fluid, and g, so this becomes my mass, or this is the weight. This is the weight. Now what happens? The pressure at this point is, say, P, and pressure at this point is, say, P plus dp, and this is the W coming downward. Now see what is happening. We are now going to derive a simple expression for finding out the static pressure from the surface of a liquid. Now, once you understand this, that as we move down the liquid, pressure increases, a natural corollary that as we move up, pressure will decrease. And that is evident, say when we go up in the atmosphere, pressure goes on decreasing because atmosphere becomes rarer and rarer. Now, if I take this element under consideration and show that it is P here, it is P plus dp, and it is W. If I write its, say, Newton's law or free body diagram and the equations. So it will be P plus dP into area. So that is the force, minus P into area is equal to W, that is the weight, which is equal to dy, which is equal to dy, then rho g, dy rho g and a, because I know the total weight of this. Now if I do this, I will get dp into a is equal to, here I will get rho g dy into a, so a will get cancelled and I will get dp is equal to rho g dy. Now if I integrate this, integration of dp is equal to integration of rho g dy from p naught to p. If I want to find out the pressure at any point, arbitrary point p, from p naught to p, and if I integrate this from say 0 to y, or suppose 0 to h rather, if I call it as h, then what will happen? This will become p minus p naught is equal to rho g h. So finally what I get, this is equal to p naught plus rho g h. So this is my derivation for static pressure. Now one important thing about this pressure, that is the static pressure that we have, is evident from another property of fluid, which you must know at this particular moment, so that I am taking this property here. Now see what is written here. Fluids in equilibrium exert pressure at right angles to the surface of contact. Now actually you have answered this question. When a balloon was there, it was filled with water. When the piston is pressed, water oozes out and it comes necessarily in the radial direction. It indicates that it is in the normal direction. Now we'll prove this with the help of a mechanics. Now suppose this is a container. In the container there is liquid, and assume that the P to A is the force exerted. Direction is P A exerted. Now by Newton's third law, there is an immediate reaction along the same direction. So the force exerted will be along this direction if I assume the force exerted by the liquid in this direction, because these are equal and opposite forces. If this is the case, I will have a net resultant force in this direction, which will have a component along this direction and along this direction. So the x component will move the liquid in the horizontal direction. Y component, when the x component moves the liquid in the horizontal direction, there is no scope for the liquid to move because it is contained here and we have restricted its motion. So it is clear that whenever we have the fluid in equilibrium, it always exerts pressure at right angles. And that is evident. Suppose I have a container like this, in which I fill the liquid. So the pressure exerted is shown essentially along this direction. So pressure is always normal to the surface. It is always normal to the surface. So this is a very important property. Now next important point is, a liquid may exert thrust greater than its weight. Now this is a very important thing and a paradoxical concept, and students find it difficult when they want to give an answer. Now you can see here, I have given you the container. That container is such that its height is h, and the area is restricted here at the bottom, at the top. Then what happens, if I see the total weight of the liquid is weight of the liquid present in this part plus weight of the liquid present in this part. Okay, but the height is h. So whether this part is present or not will not make any difference on the pressure exerted here. So the pressure is going to be rho g into h at this point. and multiply by this, the area of the base will give the force. Okay. Now, if this is the force, you will find that the liquid weight is going to be less than the volume of the cylinder if its height would have been capital H. So, this particular reduction in weight which is present gives you the result that weight of the liquid is less than the thrust exerted by the fluid on the bottom surface. Now, this is important in designing of certain fluid static equipments, and you must keep this particular in mind. Now, with this you have learned some important fluid properties, and if you want to do further reading, once again I refer Fluid Mechanics by White. You can go through, or you can refer Bunsell for certain simple numerical examples. And with this, say we'll session. Thank you.